Hello all, welcome to the ninth version of the KFPS College Tour. This college is about preparation on the inspection season and is held by Jong KFPS. My name is Sietske Venja and I'm the chairwoman of Jong KFPS. And before we start with the college, I would like to take the opportunity to tell you something about Jong KFPS. Jong KFPS is an association for, as it says, young people to make them enthusiastic about the Friesian horse bread. How we do that is to organize all kind of activities throughout the year within all the Netherlands and sometimes also abroad. Activities that could be clinics or when we go to different mag ik nog een keer? Dit wordt de laatste keer, ja. Breeding stations.
Je gaat er helemaal opnieuw?
Ja, mag dat?
Ja hoor.
Of kan je knippen plakken? Dan doen we alleen het laatste stukje.
Ja, niet heel veel.
Nou, wat makkelijker is.
Doe maar, ik ben helemaal opnieuw.
Ik was er bijna.
Doe maar rustig om, hè?
Ja.
Oké. Hello all, welcome to the ninth version of the KFPS College Tour. This one is held by Jong KFPS and it's about preparations on the inspection season. My name is Sietske Veenje and I'm the chairwoman of Jong KFPS. Before we start with the college, I would like to tell you something about Jong KFPS. It's an association for young people to make them enthusiastic about the Friesian horse bread. We do that by organizing all kind of activities throughout the year within the Netherlands, but also sometimes abroad. Activities include clinics about sports and breeding. Also, we visit all kind of horse breed stables. And by this way, we try to teach people about the Friesian horse bread, and in that way, you can learn a lot from Jong KFPS. Today, the college will be led by Diana Posma. She's one of our board members. And after the presentation, there's a Q&A with Jelle van der Weijden. Jelle is also a Jong KFPS member, and he has his own stable here in the Netherlands. He's very experienced in this work field, so that's why we invited him to join us tonight. Now I'm giving the word to Diana Posma.
Well, hello, my name is Diana Posma, and I'm going to tell you something about the preparation on the inspection season. Today we are going to talk about preparing your own horse for the judging season. We will give you some tips on how you can optimally prepare your horse for an inspection. And I want to point out that there's no standard way, so you can do it all by yourself if you want to. First of all, I'm going to tell you what we are going to talk about. First, we will discuss the why aspect, what's your goal and what are your expectations. Then I will explain what kind of inspections there are and how inspections for fall work. I also give some tips on how you can respond to expectations and where it all begins. We will also talk about preparing your horse and how you can do it by yourself, and whether you can possibly take your horse to a training stable if you want that. Then we will look at how things go after the inspections. And finally, we will have a live Q&A with Jelle van der Weijden. And we have prepared a couple of questions. So first of all, there are several predicates to be obtained according to the stud book. Therefore, set your own expectations. For example, do you expect your horse to achieve a certain predicate? During the college tour on Thursday, April 8th, everything will be explained about these predicates, which is why we will not discuss that today, because it will be on April 8th. There are several reasons to put your horse up for inspections. For example, if you would like your horse to increase a predicate, a goal could be a possible increase in your horse value if you want to sell it, or to expand your own breeding and mare line. Set an expectation for yourself before you get your horse inspected. The KFPS organizes inspections for every age and gender. There are five types of inspections. First of all, the studbook inspections is a very important thing. These studbook inspections are open to foals, 3-year-olds and all the foal bookmares, and also geldings, for inclusion in the studbook and possible get a start declaration. Then we have the breeding days. These are organized by the breeding associations and are open to all classes except for stallions. The third one are the fall inspections. Fall shows can be organized by members of the KFPS. At fall shows, only falls are judged. And the next one are the fall book stallion inspections. They are also organized by the KFPS and are open to 3-year and older fall book stallions. And the last one will be the central inspection. The horses, those horses maybe already have a first premium in the same year. So if you get your horse to a inspection in this year, 2021, it can get an invitation to the central inspections if it gets a first premium star. Due to the coronavirus, currently only locations judging is organized. This means that the inspections take place at the location where your horse is being prepared for inspection. These location inspections are broadcasted live and can also be viewed afterwards, so you can watch it again. And at kfps.nl, and then leading to the KFPS, you will find under regulations and guidelines the link to inspection regulations, and there are everything I described in our is in this document. So first of all, I'm going to tell you about foals, of course. Just like other horses, foals can go to the inspection as well. This is possible during the breeding days and the breeding associations of foal inspections. And in 2021, participation is also free. Foal inspections at the KFPS are so free, and the KFPS offers the possibility to have the foal shipped on the premises. During the most breeding days and foal shows, handlers are arranged by the studbook. They can also bring your foal, go to the location. So you do not have to do that by yourself, and you can watch your foal in the arena. Previously, foals were judged separately in both walk and trot, so he can run free to the arena. And since 2019, foals are presented in on a rope, eigenlijk. This is because during the judging, the foals have to deal with many horses and rings at the same time. If you look at a judging day, there will be a lot of arenas, and your foal can get out sometimes. The foal enters along with the mare on a leash and is set up for the judges. At the indication of the jury is a triangle walked, and the foal remains on the leash, and the handler holds both mare and foal. After the walk, the foal is released for 2 trotting laps, using the entire judging track. And after this, the foal is caught, and the mare and foal leave the judging arena. Because the foal is presented in the walk on the leash, it's important that you start learning that to your foal. It's therefore advisable to practice this in advance, so to increase the chance that your foal will show itself optimally. You can practice this at home by having both mare and foal walk with you. It's not a problem if the foal stays with the mother. This is also allowed in the inspection arena. Unlike the older horses, foals do not have to be made ready for the inspection. However, it's important that you have your foal well cleaned at the day of the inspection. And sometimes people choose to shave the foal, but that's not mandatory. To get to the location of the judging, you will have to transport your foal, of course. And practicing this ahead of time will provide less stress for both your horse and your foal, and also yourself. having foals inspected is not mandatory, but having them chipped is. A foal can be chipped from 6 weeks old until he is 6 months old. When you take your foal to the inspection, the chipping is done at the inspection premises. It's a choice you made. In that case, the chip is free, but if you have the vet to come to your stable, yeah, of course, there are some costs involved. Then we are going to the next thing. How to act on expectations. First, you can take a critical look at your own horse. Does it meet the requirements of your stated goal? At the inspection, your horse will be judged on breed, conformation, leg work, walk and trot. The walk and the trot comes double. There are certain requirements that a horse must meet. For example, when you have a mare, you to go to the for inclusion in the stud book. Yeah, for example, it's a requirement for inclusion in the stud book that a mare's height should be at least 1 meter and 54 centimeters. If the quality of conformation and movement is sufficient, mares can also be declared a star. In this case, the height must be 1 meter and 56 centimeters. If your mare is smaller than 1 meter and 56 centimeters, it cannot receive a star certificate. This example already shows that you should take a good look at your own horse. In this way, you can estimate whether your goal and expectations are attainable. To get a good idea of what the judging is like, it's open to everyone to visit the KFPS judging. It's also possible to watch the inspections on YouTube, so you can get a good idea of what an inspection is like. So you can look at all by yourself. Also, the KFPS organized course for judging. These consist of theory evenings and practical meetings. During these courses, you learn everything about judging a Friesian horse, and you can apply the acquired theory in practice. If this is a little bit too much for you, you can also buy the book, Judging the Friesian Horse, of course. This allows you to read through the theory at a time at your own choosing, and this book is available by the KFPS. Yeah, of course, it's possible and advisable also to ask the opinion expert of an expert. You can contact a training stable, a stallion owner, an experienced breeder, of course, to see what their opinion is about your own horse. Within Jong KFPS, we offer experienced breeding coaches, and they want to provide you with advice and knowledge sharing about the Friesian horse. Several training stables regularly practice with inspection horses in by hand. You can contact a training stable, of course, to see if your horse is suitable for the inspection. In this way, your horse can be examined with a critical eye by someone from the outside. Well, first of all, it has to start somewhere. Where do you start? Where does the preparation for inspection begin? It starts initially with the education of your horse. Can your horse walk along with a normally on a string? I've already covered this a little bit in slide 4 with the foals, so I'm not going to discuss that a lot. but if is your horse older, then you can make the first preparations by yourself. For the inspections, it's important that your horse is presented in a good condition, with the right muscular. You can make a start with this all by yourself. For example, with a 3-year-old horse, you can already start to lunge and start getting used to a bridle, a girt, and you can, well, if you know how, start lunging it and later possibly adding a side rein. When you have a green horse, it's important that you build up the lunging slowly. It's new for your horse, so don't expect it to do the same thing as an experienced horse and respond to your aids. Be clear and consistent in both your voice and your body language. When your horse is ready to be launched with a bridle, you could first put a halter over the bridle, and this way you don't put pressure on the bit yet. If your horse is well behaved, you can leave the halter off and attach the lunge line to the bit. You can also put a lunge girt on your horse. When you do this for the first time, please be careful. So always keep paying attention, because your horse is young and he finds it scary, maybe. When your horse is used to the bridle and the girth and the lunging goes well, you can use a side rein or side ropes to give your horse the necessary position and bend. Pay attention. It's not the intention that you force your horse into a position. Making rides too tight, it's not going to work. At inspection, your horse will be presented by the hand. Practice this at home or at a training stable, so your horse is not unfamiliar with it. This is also, if you watch on the slideshow, your first your horse have to stand still in front of the judge. It's the above picture. And then your horse have to walk in by hand. That's the beneath picture. So it's very important if you train this one with your horse. Well, the next thing we are going to talk about is preparing for the inspections. Yeah, should you do it by yourself or would you choose a training stable to do that? Throughout the Netherlands, there are training stables that are specialized in making a Friesian horse ready for inspection. Depending on the experience of your horse, yourself, and the possible circumstances, you can decide whether you will do it yourself or if you prefer to outsource it. If you do not have any experience with the preparation of a horse for an inspection, it's advisable to take your horse to an experienced training stable so that your horse is optimally prepared for the inspection. As there are training stables all over the Netherlands, you can look at which training stable is nearby or which you have a good feeling about. If you have decided to take your horse to a training stable, you usually do this prior to the examination. This means that the examination will take place at the same time as the training. Consult with a training stable about the training period, because this is different about each horse. It's also important that you remain involved in your horse training, even during the time your horse is at the training stable. After all, it's your horse. You can, for example, drop by to see how he or she is doing it. And if he or she meets in your expectations, of course. Some people choose to take a halter tamed horse away, while others want to work with the horses themselves first. In this choice, you're free. It's your horse. You can do whatever you want. Tonight, we will give you a horse. We will give you a kind of tips. There's no fixed manual on how to do this. It depends on your horse and on yourself if you already have the experience. A horse that's still green generally needs more training before adjusting than a horse that already knows something. As a result, the time it takes to prepare the horse for the inspections can be can vary from 4 to 8 weeks. As mentioned, this is in consultation with the training stable. Of course, we're going to talk about if you want to do it yourself, of course. If you want to prepare your horse by yourself, here are a few useful points you have to deal with. First of all, every horse is different. Therefore, there's no set schedule. Get to know your horse and adjust the training and feeding schedule accordingly. It's important that your horse is in good shape in the preparation for the inspection for an optimal performance. Also, it's important to have several checkups that can assert your horse conditions. For example, think about a dentist. If your horse has dental problems, and you put the bridle on it, that can cause tension. And, well, this is at the expense of your horse performance. Also, go over your horse weakness and strengths and adjust your training schedule to this. For example, with one horse, it's necessary to focus on a broader stride. And with another horse, the focus is on straightening the top line, for example. Also, it's very important to establish a consistent schedule to build the muscles. This should be built up slowly in a young, a green horse. So don't take your horse, a very green horse, 6 times a week in the lunging arena, but start with 2-3 times a week and give the horse the time he needs. Next, set up a feeding schedule for your horse to match the training. Because the horse knows have to go to work, you can ask more of him. Some horses require more food supplementation than others. Make sure that your horse is in a good shape and has enough energy for the training. If necessary, you can consult feed specialists who can tell you which feed and which quantity is suitable for your horse in training. When you go to Google and you Google feed specialist horse, you will have your answer. As also mentioned before, it's possible to ask for advice at the training stable. You can take your horse to a viewing evening, after a few weeks, of course. And here your horse can get used to walking by the hand and just to bringing the horse in front of you. Of course, grooming is also a part of the preparation for the judging day. Try to get your horse in a tight, shiny coat. You can achieve this by adding linseed oil to your horse diet, for example. Also make sure that you rinse your horse well after sweating. This prevents your horse from getting a brown glow. During the inspection, your horse will also be judged on its black color. So it's very important that you have a black horse and not a brown horse. The black color and the coat are part of the breed type. Before the judging, the horses are generally groomed by shaving off the shaggy hair. This includes the beard, the ears and the pipes. There are certain requirements that must be met. For example, the ears may not be shaved out and the touch hairs must remain in place. So don't shave them off, please. at kfps.nl, I'm sorry, under the heading the KFPS, and then you go with your mouse to the regulations and guidelines, you will find the inspection regulations, and everything is described there. And also with regard to the grooming. And leading up to the judging, you can get your horse used to clipping and shaving. If you do this in a day in advance and you accidentally shaved wrong, it could happen. You will see this clearly on the day of the inspection. Therefore, it's best to do this in a few days in advance, because the hair can always come off, but you can't put it back. So be careful with that, please. The day before the inspection, you can use it to put a finishing touch on the body and on the coat by washing it completely and detangling the manes. Another important tip is check your horse for mud fever in a timely manner and treat your horse if necessary, so you don't have a mud fever for your horse. During the judging, of course, it's custom to present your horse with hoof trimming and with horseshoes. Most judging and breeding days are held on the grass. And in order for the horse to be properly stable on this grass, you can turn a gag into the shoe. And this works like the studs of a soccer boot. On average, irons are replayed, of horseshoes are replayed every 6 to 8 weeks. It is recommended that this be placed in 3-4 weeks before the inspection. In this way, your horse has enough time to get used to his new shoes. In the last week before the inspection, try to reduce your training a little. This so you can keep up the energy of your horse, of course, and the muscle pain is smaller. Of course, it's important that your horse keeps moving. So you can do this by walking your horse or by doing a short lunge training. A very important thing is also make sure you are on time on the day of the inspections. You must still you have to register, of course, at the secretariat. The passport must be checked and you will receive starting numbers. 3-year-old horses must be measured before they enter the ring. Keep this in mind in your schedule and make sure you are on time on your section. This prevents a lot of stress by both you and your horse. And of course, after the inspection, you also have the thing. If the outcome of the inspection is not your liking, you have the option to have your horse re-inspected. You can only bring your horse to the inspection once a year. The only option to do this twice is to participate in the re-inspection. During a re-inspection, your horse will be re-evaluated. What is extremely important to know is that the decision at the re-inspection counts. Did your mare receive the second premium star during the first inspection? But did you expect a first premium maybe? Then a re-inspection can be the solution. But you have the chance that your mare will be declared a third premium studbook. It's not the case that the highest predicate counts. No, it's the decision on the re-inspection. That's final also. I think we now have a Q&A with Jelle van der Weijden. Of course, he is sitting nearby. And I don't know if you would like to come here. Yes, and thank you all.
Well, hello, Jelle. This is Sietke speaking again, but I'm not in the viewing moment. We have prepared a few questions for you, and the first one is, why are the inspections in a triangular court?
Okay, the reason horses are inspected in a triangular court is that it gives the judges the ability to view the horse from all the sides. They can judge the front, the hindquarters, and the sidewalls. When a horse has an incorrect leg position, one you can see in the movement. Because of the shape of the court, the judge sees the horse trotting away and trotting too far. Next to that, because the court has a triangular shape, This demands the horse to reduce the speed in the trot. Judges like to see the horse collect the movement in the harness. By doing this, the hind leg has to step under, which enables the judge to evaluate the functionality of the hindquarters.
Aha, okay, thank you. We have a second question. We heard Diana saying that the horse should have horseshoes for inspection. But why is that? Why does the horse have to stand on horseshoes?
The horse needs to stand on horseshoes during and before inspection to make sure that every horse gets inspected in an equal way. Horses on horseshoes move generally better with shoes than without shoes. And next to that, there is a practical advantage. When the inspections are on the grass, they can attack cramps to the horseshoes.
Aha. Another question. Can the horse still walk in a pasture day and night in addition to training for the inspection?
It's not advisable to house a horse in the pasture when it's trained for the inspection. The horse needs to be in optimal condition for the inspection, and it is easier to control the diet when he is in the stables. Next to that, the Friesian horse can quickly turn brown because of the combination of training, sweating, and the sun. After all, we want a jet black Friesian. We also want the horse to be fresh in the inspection. When a horse walks on the pasture, it can lose a lot of energy, which we will prevent to the use at the inspection.
The next question is, how much does it cost to prepare a horse for inspection, approximately?
The cost of preparing for inspection at the training stable are around 170 euro a week. Mostly the horses stay there for 6 to 8 weeks, and that make a cost of 1190 euro for the training. In addition to that, the horse needs a farrier. Mostly they cost around 100 euro a horse, to include the preparing for inspection cost, which cost around 1500 euro, including transport and unforeseen costs.
How does it always make sense? Does it always take sense to take a horse to an inspection?
It's not always beneficial to take a horse to an inspection. When a horse flows are too big or does not walk regularly, the horse cannot be included in the stud book. So it's important to take a critical look to your horse or make sure that you get an expert's opinion before you introduce the horse at the inspection.
And then we have a final question. What are the advantages of a horse that has been inspected?
When a horse gives good results at the curring, it can be primed. The higher the prime, the higher the horse value. In addition, we like to see a practical rich pedigree behind the horse in breeding. If all the model lines after a horse are star of higher, then we speak of a full paper. That can increase security for good offsprings in your breeding.
Well, thank you very much. Very clear explanations. Also, thank you, Diana, for the presentation. That was it.
Thank you.